Yeah, just one huge question and one small one. Yesterday I was really shocked to read that the Filipino people favors, according to the Pew International Survey, an unconstrained executive power. So, the question is, how did we come to this point when our people think that executive power unconstrained by the judiciary and the legislature is a solution to our development problem, which of course includes issues of governance and regulations, and so on. My small question relates to the fact that certain regulations have unintended consequences, as mentioned earlier, and often they are right based. So, for example, people would claim, particularly militant students, that free education is a right. Okay. And yet it hurts certain segments of the population, particularly the disadvantaged and the poor. In fact, are basically empirically disadvantaged when you provide free universal tuition fees, as well as other kind of forms of populist policies. So how do you reconcile this? And it's the same empirical evidence that we can show where you have this differential impact based on so-called rights to protect the weak. The minimum wage is an example that we gave in our book, the unintended consequences.